One day I was sitting in this living room, not with all these paintings, because they came later from my sister. She didn't paint them, but she made me buy them. She said, you have to have these paintings. And so they sort of expand the rest of my apartment and make me think I live in this very 17th century room, which I'm sharing with you today. So I was sitting in this room and I got a call. It was 1973 and I got a call from my friend Nancy Bacall. Nancy Bacall and I were very close friends, very, very close friends. She lived down the street here from where I live in New York today. And we'd been introduced by Leonard Cohen. So in a way it was sort of part of the family legacy of having met Leonard Cohen and then all the things that happened to me, including recording all of his songs and getting to know him as the most fantastic man. What a wonderful fellow. I never had a romance with him, so I guess I was lucky to have him as a friend. I know I was. Anyway, Nancy called me and she said, it was 1973, and she said, I know that you are looking for new things and you're kind of lost as far as, so I had told her that, you know, she was a good friend. And she said, I'm bringing over an album and I want you to listen to it, put the needle on this cut and just listen to this song and then call me. So I listened to the song and I didn't call her, I called Hal Prince. And I said, Hal, he answered my phone, which I was amazed at, but he said, oh no, I know who you are. Both Sides Now and all that. And I said, this is a wonderful song that you have here. It's great. And he said, yes, it is. It is. It's a great song. He said, about 200 people have recorded it already. And I said, well, I don't care. I have to record it. It's fantastic. It suits me to a T. And so that's how I came in contact with Stephen Sondheim. I didn't know who he was until then. And of course, I've recorded many songs of Sondheim's, including a big album with an orchestra and a lot of my favorite songs. And that is part of a TV special. I was thrilled to get to be able to do it on television for PBS, my favorite place, or one of my favorites in the world.
Good times and bum times, I've seen them all, and my dear, I'm still here. Plush velvet sometimes, sometimes just pretzels and beer, but I'm here. I've stuffed the dailies in my shoes, strung ukuleles, sung the blues, seen all my dreams disappear, but I'm here. I've slept in shanties, guest of the WPA, and I'm here. Danced in my scanties, $3 a night was the pay, and I'm here. I've stood on bread lines with the best, watch while the headlines did the rest. In the Depression, was I depressed? Nowhere near. I met a big financier, and I'm here. I've been through Gandhi, Windsor, and Wally's affair, but I'm here. Amos and Andy, Mahjong and platinum hair, and I'm here. Been through a cottage in Key West, macrobiotic zen and est. Back in the 60s, did I protest loud and clear? I've been through Lindsay Lohan, and I'm here. I've gotten through Herbert and J. Edgar Hoover. To Herbert J. Edgar Hoover, anything else is a laugh. I've been through Reno, I've been through Beverly Hills, and I'm here. Reefers and vino,
rest cures religion and pills, and I'm here. Been called a pink commie tool, got through its stink of my pool. I should have gone to an acting school, that seems clear. Still someone said she's sincere, so I'm here. Black sable one day, next day it goes into hawk, but I'm here. Top billing Monday, Tuesday you're touring in stock, but I'm here. First you're another slow sometimes just pretzels and beer, but I'm here.